And let's continue our storm team coverage now live in Lancaster County. News 8's News 8's morning reporter Katelyn Smith live in Quarryville with a look at the conditions there. Katelyn, first of all, I apologize, and second, good morning.
Good morning, Jerry. We just have crews everywhere this morning, so I understand why there's a confusion. We are standing here at the intersection of 372 and 222 in Quarryville, and you can take a look. Traffic's starting to pick up a little bit this morning, but the road conditions here seem pretty good. You can see that there is a thin layer of snow kind of piled up in the center of the intersection, and definitely a lot of snow around the sides of the roadways. But this road in particular, 222, when we came in on it from Lancaster, we're noticing some areas very clear like this, other ones patchy, others ice covered. And PennDOT says that that's what you're going to find on a lot of the roadways that are not that well traveled. We're talking about 501, 72, 272, and of course 222 here and 372. You'll just be driving along and all of a sudden you might come across an icy patch or a snow covered patch, so keep an eye out for that. But then there are roads that are completely covered with snow, and we got some video of one of those earlier today. We're talking about Columbia Avenue in East Hempfield Township. It is just coated with snow. We also talked to a driver earlier today who told us that 999 and Manor Township was very icy, so be careful for that. One of the problems PennDOT says it's running into is that there is so much snow on the side of the road piled up here. I mean, this comes up to about my knee. And then if you can see across the street behind me here, I mean, that's probably comes up to about my neck, it seems. And that is causing some drifting snow onto the roadways. So PennDOT is out trying to get up some of that snow. It has 52 trucks out on the road. They've been out since 4 this morning. It only had about a handful of crews out overnight. And that's because it said that with how cold it is, laying down any material really wasn't going to do any good. Finally, Jerry, we want to show you. We showed you this fire hydrant earlier, and I didn't dig it out because I wanted to be able to show our viewers that are watching this half hour just how bad this is. If you have a fire hydrant near your house, make sure that you clear this away, because if there were to be an emergency, that could definitely be a hazard. Jerry, we'll send it back to you.
Yeah, good advice. All right, Kate.